Okay, who's seen the movies lately? Star is Born? Excellent movie. Not much to say about that one myself at the moment, but the one that really caught me was Bohemian Rhapsody. And they had a Live Aid shot in there. And I remember it. I went over to England and nothing to do but look for Hill Audio. And that's the one who actually donated the systems to that. So you went down to Bearstead out on a train track, and you took it down to Bearstead, which happens to be where the tunnel comes up from France. And I found out, here's a 5-car garage they actually cut and built all the speakers in. Malcolm Hill had a little, like a mansion out there on the hill in the middle of nowhere. It's a little two-car little asphalt lane that got you out in this little town of Bearstead. And he had taken a sound system out there before the city voted in, the little town had voted in bringing the tunnel up, and he'd played audio of a freeway simulating that all weekend long. So it gave the town an idea what was going to hit them. But it's all a system that was built in the garage, and that really got me because Matthew Polk started in his garage, and I started in my garage, and Dave Clark designed our bass cell and our horn-loaded double 12 that we took and made ourselves famous with in 79 on through. He had actually designed the bass cell for Wonderland Music, and we'd used that system for rentals all around town with a 5 special. We've done, shows all up and down the area with Wonderland's truck, and then I went and built 24 of those things and ran them around with the Audiolite logo on them. But since the movie came back with the Live Aid, just having the ability to go see that hill. They also had, a little bit farther down in the town, they had 2 dairy barns, or the big metal barns out in the dairy farm area. One of them had AC/DC, and they put the sound system together for the tour up in this barn on one end of the property, and then the other end of the property they had another barn, and the little windows on the corner there. But inside of that, they were building mixing consoles, the amplifiers, the crossovers, the Hill Audio designed and built during that time frame, which was back in the 80s when Live Aid first came out, which was part of the movie, where Queen, delivered real well on that. And the audio in Bohemian Rhapsody, excellent. They put together a lot of shots of in the studio and all the things that they put together. I suggest everybody go see that just because it really is a good documentary. But the funny thing is about the bookkeeper, she sat in the corner with the windows open in the morning. She didn't worry about the guys cranking the AC/DC down the end there. She mentioned that the dairy horse drove her nuts in the morning. Just clip, clop, clip, clop, clip. That drove her nuts. Just little things you learn. But I went and saw Celestion, which basically, the funniest thing he said there, after hearing a pair of double eights and a pair of 18s, and they just, out in the middle of the room, I just walked through there, and it says, that sound field's perfect. You didn't know where the speakers were. You walked through them, you kind of got an impression, but the sound field snapped back into place, and I'll have a chance to bring a couple out and demonstrate them one day with the 5s and the 8s. They don't make them anymore, but his comment was, some of the new places out in town are only 125 years old. I'm like, okay, they got bombed during World War II up there in Ipswich, England. And then the third day I was out there, I went and saw Wharfdale, Leeds, Mackenzie, and Fane. They're out in a little place called Leeds, England. You walked in there, and one of my impressions was they kept track of all the speaker parts. And they kept in this big leather-bound manual, which was about this wide and about that thick, and it's gotten to be about that thick. So one woofer, they labeled the woofer, and they gave all the different parts and things across there, and rolled them in there. Oh, that would be a recounter's dream to have that book. They had a little old lady who was about 80 years old. She's making the tweeters. These guys have been there for years. You can see the place has just got the patina of age. And, they're from building the dome tweeters and the woofers and other things across the assembly line and the rest of it. And the age of these gals, all up and down, from the 20s to 60s and even an 80-year-old, they're working in there. It was just kind of like family affair. Been kind of like a lot of fun to go
What's the name of this outfit?
Leeds. It was in Leeds.
Leeds Speaker Company?
Yeah, Wharfdale, Mackenzie, Fane, were all combined. That's it. Any questions?
This program has been a production of the Southeastern Michigan Woofer and Tweeter Marching Society. Opinions expressed during this program are those of the individual speaking and not necessarily the opinion of the Southeastern Michigan Woofer and Tweeter Marching Society.